welterweight fight. All right, we send it back inside the octagon. Here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is three rounds in the UFC welterweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, the future, Ian Machado Garry! And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner, ladies and gentlemen, presenting the former UFC welterweight champion, Kamaru, the Nigerian Nightmare, Usman.
Ready to fight? Ready. Do it.
All right, early round action here, and keep an eye on that jab of Kamaru Usman, right? I don't have to tell a lot of you who are listening tonight that he has gone to great lengths to develop that with Trevor Whitman. And that has really helped him set up his takedowns. But he wants to box tonight. He feels like this matchup is a striking matchup for him. We'll see if he can put those words into action here tonight. Oh, going for the takedown here. Right hook to the head block. All right, so there's the takedown from Kamaru Usman. We know he has fallen in love with his jab at his hands a little bit, but back to his bread and butter early in this one.
Well, that's his ruse, right? For as good as he is in the stand-up, for as powerful as the jab is, it's always going to be the wrestling of Kamaru Usman that's going to lead the day. Whether it's offensive or defensive, Kamaru Usman will wrestle if he ever wants to be the champion again. Massive shot from the top.
Another ground and pound strike lands.
Oh, high-level stuff here with the ground and pound by Kamaru Usman.
Right to the neon belly.
Oh, getting leaky now. The hard ground and pound has opened up a cut.
Oh, outstanding combination of ground and pound punches here by Usman.
Man, this is some serious ground and pound here, DC. He's not just staying busy for the sake of staying busy. These strikes are doing damage.
Oh, yeah, no pity pat to this guy. This guy's trying to land, and he's trying to land effective strikes.
Don't allow him to hold him down. Keep moving. Keep moving.
Really good job to land these strikes from top position.
All right, dominant position here. He's got the full mount. A lot of different ways he can go here. Maybe try to find an arm bar or just get the ground and pound.
He can attack submissions, but those submissions will present themselves once he is landing that brutal ground and pound he is known for. Because then his opponent will start to get a little bit desperate to get out from under him, which will then in turn leave arms dangling, or he'll turn to his knees and get choked out. Nice shots landing from the top position.
He's
got to be careful here.
Well, we got a lot of blood now, ladies and gentlemen. I think my mother just turned off the TV, but every time that area gets targeted, that cut is getting worse and closer.
That'll do it! Kamaru Usman!
Oh, my goodness.
So what a moment in this man's career. A huge finish in front of a capacity crowd. After party's gonna be on fire. How about it?
I mean, I'm just sitting here stunned, because to watch a young athlete have a performance like this was really amazing. The finishing instincts, his ability to close the show, it was next level. It was amazing, John.
All right, we set it inside for the official decision. Here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Dean has called a stop to this contest at 2 minutes, 37 seconds of the very first round. Declaring the winner by TKO, Kamaru, the Nigerian Nightmare, Usman.
All right, Kamaru Usman, your winner by TKO. You heard it there from Bruce Buffer. He established his jab early and